Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. I am Fi and today we're going to be diving into the good news that you need to hear, okay? So the good news that you need to hear, the good news that's coming your way. What I need for you to do is to get calm, get relaxed, get into a nice vibe. That way you could be guided by your intuition when choosing between the three options that I have before you, or that I'm about to have before you. Okay, so once you're calm, take a look at these options. So for option number one, we have the King of Hearts. Okay. And for option number two, we have the Three of Diamonds. I know it's like a little bit low lighting, so just kind of like, I mean, a little bit. You should be able to see. Option number three, we have the Four of Wands. Sorry. We have the Four of Clubs. Okay. Now, again, I'm going to show you your options. So, option one, option two, and option number three. Once you feel like you know which one is calling out to you, then go ahead and click on that description box down below and then click on the timestamp for whichever one you feel the most called to. And then I will see you at your pile selection. If anything I say today resonates for you, then please make sure you like, you comment, you subscribe, and you share this video with somebody that you feel needs it. Also, when you subscribe, hit that bell so you can be notified whenever I upload a video. Let's go ahead and get started with group number one. Okay, so hello, pile number one people, or option number one people. You chose the King of Hearts, okay? And you also have here, just shuffled, you have the Queen of Diamonds. So the good news for option number one people is that your sensitivity and your creativity is like you're using your spirituality, your sensitivity, your creativity to make your personal success in the physical manifest. So it's like you have some sort of gifts and abilities, spiritual gifts, spiritual abilities, and it doesn't have to necessarily be spiritual, but I feel like your spiritual gifts are assisting you in creating some sort of, I'm hearing finances and wealth. So your spiritual gift may just be creating building your finances and wealth in this in the near future. Okay, so with this King of Cups and the Queen of Pentacles, I see that you guys are really using your sensitivity as a superpower, and I feel like you're very tapped in to the spiritual realm, but in a very balanced way, to where you are like nurturing yourself. And because you're nurturing yourself and you are focusing in on yourself, you are allowing in a beautiful abundance in the physical. Things are changing in the physical. You're changing so much spiritually that things are just manifesting more quickly for you in the physical. So expect changes to your finances. Expect changes to your career. Some of you guys are getting I'm hearing a new house, a new job. There's just so many positive changes for pile number one people. And I feel like it's all because there's this internal change that's happening. A lot of internal changes that are facilitating external changes for pile number one people. Let's get your oracle card. This is going to be quick messages, by the way. So we have woman holding a heart. Okay. For your oracle card. And I'm just going to pull one more card for you guys. One more oracle. Yeah. Yes. Yes. Okay. Yes. Yes. Oh, I love it. Okay. So, okay. Hold on. So we have woman holding a heart. And then we also had rest and rejuvenation pop out. So it's like what I was saying, your heart chakra, your heart space is opening and activating, and this is allowing for you to attract in so many beautiful things, but it's also allowing for emotions that were creating blockages in your life or things that were in your subconscious. Those things that were creating blockages in your subconscious are coming to the surface in order for you to heal them. And it's allowing for this healing to happen with this rest and rejuvenation. So right now you may be in a period where you are really like focusing inward, where you are maybe not going out as much, and you're just diving into yourself, being in silence, diving into your spirituality, learning and growing, and you're just really focused inward, right? So that King of Cups, right? So, and really feeling very sensitive. Okay, you could be in this energy now, or this energy could be coming, but when just know whenever this energy hits, okay, you're feeling this. Very sensitive, very hard on your sleeve. Okay, just know that this is facilitating you manifesting your abundance, you manifesting your dream life. Okay, you really stepping into your power. Okay, on the spiritual plane as well as the physical plane, there's this beautiful balance, but I'm also hearing tug of war. So I feel like you guys may feel a little bit pulled in between the two, but you'll be learning how to balance that and really just kind of get into a state of allowance. You guys are moving into a state of allowance and accepting. Some of you guys are going to be accepting what was in order to begin something new, really releasing and letting go of what no longer serves you, all for the betterment of you. And is there any, oh, and at the back of the deck, which made me smile, was action, because it's just again saying that you will know when you need to take action towards something. You'll feel it intuitively because you're becoming so in tune with yourself. I feel like the actions that you take, okay, after going through this, journey that you're going through right here, where you're diving more deeper into yourself, where things are coming up from your subconscious, where you're like really releasing things, letting go of things, where you are trusting yourself more, trusting your intuition more, where you are very focused, because I feel like you will be very focused. As you're going through this, you'll be able to, like I said, tap into your intuition to where you'll know when it's time to take action and make money moves, make power moves. I feel like spirit will be assisting you with that. So it's like you don't really have to question what it is that I have to do now. Like, what moves do I need to make now? And just be all in your head. Don't be all in your head, because everything will happen naturally upon number one. You have to be all in your spirit. You have to be all into your intuition and just allowing that to guide you. Okay, that's what I have for you guys. Pile number one. I'm gonna go ahead and move on to pile number two, people. So hello, option number two, people. You chose the three of diamonds. Okay, you chose the three of diamonds, and I just heard locked out of heaven. I was just singing locked out of heaven, from Bruno Mars. So that may be a message. There may be a message there, or you may have recently listened to that song. Someone could have made you feel like someone could have made you feel like you couldn't reach a point, in your life that you were destined to reach. Like someone could have held you back in some way by what they said or what they did, or tried to like keep you small in some way. But that's neither here nor there. Okay, let's dive into your reading, your cards, and we're gonna see the good news that is coming your way. Remember to only take what resonates and leave the rest behind. Okay, Three of Pentacles. I feel like the good news that's coming your way, option number two, people, is connections that are going to promote you, as well as this creation. You might be creating something new that becomes very successful. I also see you guys really working together with others well, whether that's family, whether that's in career, whether that's in personal relationships, deep personal relationships and connection. But there's this friendship, there's this soul bond, there's this family, there's this energy of respect is also what I'm hearing is what they're saying. There's this energy of respect coming to you. Put some respect on my name type of energy, because I'm getting that somebody played on your time. Somebody made you feel like you could never reach heaven. Somebody made you feel like you were not good enough. Somebody made you feel like you could never be that bitch. But the truth is, pile number two people, you are that bitch. You, like, and I mean that respectfully. Like, the truth is, pile number two people, the good news that's coming your way, you're really coming into this realization of, wait a minute. They said I could never do what? They said I was what? Okay. You're coming into this state of being where you're like, huh, I can do anything. I can do anything. I can build anything. I can be anything that I want to be. Everything that I want, everything that I desire, I am able to manifest. I have loving, beautiful, amazing connections in my life that support me, that uplift me, that take me to the next level. And this is the energy that you're stepping into. This is the energy that you're really moving into, okay? In this next phase of your life, I just heard. So let's add one more card to your message. Group projects is what I just heard. Success, especially if you're in school for something and you had to do a group project, or in career, you're working with someone, you had to work with together with someone on something. Know that everything is going to work out as it is supposed to, and know that everything will work out well. Okay, so we also have the Ace of Pentacles or the Ace of Diamonds. Okay, and this is saying that that old way of being, that old phase, that old the things that used to hold you back in the past, the things that really just kept you with doubt, and like even if it was relationships, because I feel like for some of you guys, it was a relationship, it was like a person or something in your life that was like, you can never be good enough. But you're leaving that behind, you're ending that cycle, and you're moving on to, you're creating a new cycle here, and you're moving on to something better. You're ready to progress. You're ready to travel. You're ready to just step into this beautiful way of being. You're ready for new opportunities. You're creating new opportunities for yourself, pile number two people. So I just see, like, it's beautiful. Let's get into your oracle card. And we have here third chakra, Archangel Chamuel. And this is the solar plexus, if I'm not mistaken, energy, right? Okay. The solar plexus energy. So this is you really, this is that I will. Right? Because I said before, it's that energy, right? I will. Your solar plexus is activating and it's saying, I will. You will no longer, no longer. And I'm hearing, what is that, a plane? Right? Because we're taking flight and we're leaving this bullshit behind. Okay? But I'm hearing, you will no longer be in my life if you make me feel down, if you make me feel low vibrational, if you make me feel that I am less than, even if it's my own self and these own negative thoughts, you're going to catch yourself whenever you're having these negative thoughts and you're going to be like, no, I clear this out. I don't resonate with that. And we're moving right the freak along. Okay. Beautiful transformation happening for you guys, pile number two. I love to see it. To whereas you're creating your reality, you're creating your own happiness, and you're not allowing anybody else to determine what makes you happy or who you are. So, your next card, we have the garden and the gate. Okay. Yes, I feel like there was something that was keeping you trapped. Okay, and you thought that it made you feel comfortable. I think this could have been an area in your life where you just created your own little comfort bubble and you thought that you were comfortable there. Like sometimes we make mistakes where we're sitting in shit or sitting in a shitty smelling room that we made a little perfect little bed in, a little pile in that smelly, stinky room, and we've got so used to the stink to where we don't even realize that it still stinks in there. Like do you read me? Like this is a situation that you could have been in, or Maybe it's a situation that you deal with in the future, but it's like you come to the realization of it smells in here and I need to move on to something better. Like I was comfortable here in my head, but I wasn't really comfortable here. I wasn't really supposed to still be here. I wasn't even supposed to be in this room in the first place. It's time to move on. This garden and the gate, she has the ability to open that gate and move out of her own restriction. So spirit is saying that the good news is you're moving out of your own restriction and you're finding the willpower to move forward positively, to make positive changes in your life and to create your desired lifestyle. So that's what I have. And then we also have appreciation at the back of the deck. Okay. Spirit is reminding you to just be appreciative of yourself. Don't be so hard on yourself, because I feel like you're very hard on yourself, and that's something that also holds you back. So just appreciate yourself, appreciate where you are, appreciate those around you that do love and support you, and just, do what you can to just move forward. Move forward. Move forward. Yes. In the most natural way possible. They're saying don't force it. Just allow it to happen with ease and really just stand your ground when it comes to those personal restrictions that you place upon yourself, as well as the restrictions that other people try to place upon you. Just stand your ground. Remember who you are and appreciate yourself for who you are. That's what I have for you guys, pound number two. We're going to move on to pound number three. And please make sure you like, comment, share, subscribe, and all that good stuff. Hello, option number three people. Welcome to your reading. It's going to be a little bit short and sweet. Thank you so much for being here. You chose the Four of Clubs or the Four of Wands. Let's dive into your good news that you need to hear. So I feel like your good news is all about your security in your home, okay? There could be upgrades happening to your home. There, this in regards to this good news, family. There could be improvements when it comes to your family life, okay? There could be also a new foundation being built. Remember, take it for how it resonates, because there's different messages for everybody. A new foundation being built either within or without, okay? I'm gonna get another card for you guys though. But family, home, security, this is the area of great improvement that I see for you guys. I see. Okay, so the area in your life that you've been really juggling, where you've been feeling like you've had to really try to work really hard to find balance in your life in this area. Okay, we have the two of diamonds, okay? So the Two of Diamonds and the Four of Wands. Yeah, I feel like that area where you feel like you've been juggling things, where things have not come easy is what Spirit is saying. Where things have not come easy, this is the area that is about to be improving for you. This is the area where things are about to settle down in. This is a settle down energy, because maybe you've been dealing with, I'm getting very underworld, very occult, very very, very shadow, very dark space type of energy, and you're about to move out of that. You're moving from one phase to the next. This is like a portal or an opening that I see that you're going through. This is portal energy. You're moving from one phase to the next, where you are moving to a lighter, you're about to have a lighter experience. There's some sort of ending that's happening here. Because you were definitely surrounded in darkness. I'm seeing someone walking in walking in darkness, looking for the light, and you're about to see it. Okay. A very spiritual pile. You were going through a very spiritual experience, pile number three. And it was very uncomfortable. And it's understandable for you to feel like what I'm saying to you is unbelievable, or it's very understandable if you just don't under you just feel very uncertain about your future. It's very understandable. But what spirit needs you to do and what I need you to do is take a deep breath and really just trust your intuition. Trust that quiet voice that maybe you haven't really been paying attention to because of the dark circumstances that maybe you've been experiencing in your life. Trust that small voice that's been telling you that everything is going to be okay, that everything that's been happening has been happening for a reason, and that's for your upcoming. Okay. At the back, we have the Jack of Spades, I believe. Okay, so with that, I feel like Spirit is saying it's time for you to bring your focus into what you do want instead of what you don't want. It's time for you to bring your focus onto what you can build instead of what is broken. It's like you have you have this broken glass, right? Spirit is asking you, what can you build with that broken glass? How can you repurpose it? There's something that you might need to repurpose. Or you will be repurposing in the future. It's like those people. I don't know if you've ever seen those videos where like these people they go and they buy broken things, like broken dressers or whatever, broken wood, broken table, a broken wooden table. They buy it and then they fix it up. So it's like things that are broken can still be fixed. Things that are broken can still be healed. And you're about to recognize that. Like the healing that's about to happen in your life is going to be so transformational. Is that a word? I think that's a word. It's nighttime. My brain is okay. But the healing that you're about to go through is about to really transform you in the way that you see things, the way that you look at things. It's very brilliant, if you ask me. Your next card is the world. Your next card, the world. Jesus. Okay, the world. Again, this is about your perspective and you shifting that perspective. Like the way that you're about to see things is going to be completely different. You're putting an end to, and again, I said I've seen a person in darkness looking for the light. You'll be able to find that light. We also have here attachment. So I feel like Spirit is saying, look, with the world and attachment, some of you guys, pawn number three, you're really, again, you're stepping through the portal. You're released. It's like something had a hold on you. It could have been a person. It could be just whatever this thing that has a hold on you and is trying to keep you in the darkness. And it's trying to keep you in the darkness. You're about to like snatch your body back from it and just walk through to the light. You're about to awaken, pile number three. That's the good news. You're about to awaken and release whatever this attachment was to you. Could be a spiritual entity or whatever. Don't be afraid. Okay? It doesn't have to be a spiritual entity, but it's something that was false. It was something that was false. It could be a false identity that you held within that you're finally like shaking. You're finally shaking and getting out of. Okay. Okay. Yes, you're releasing this false sense of being or this energy, this deception energy, this again. That person in darkness is not seeing things clearly because you are in darkness. You're searching for the light so that way you can gain that clarity. So you're really going to be able to have security in your life. Where you were uncertain, pile number three, where you were unsure about life, unsure about where your journey is being led, where you felt like you were surrounded in darkness, where you felt like you were juggling too much and you can't move on, you can't move forward. Things are just this is where your life is about to be. You're about to have this healing. You're about to have this healing. You're about to have this awakening. Life is about to change for the better. For whenever that is, don't put pressure on the timing. Don't be obsessed with timing, because we cannot control that. So the best thing for us to do, and I feel like the best thing for pound number three people to do, is focus on what you do want. Focus on cultivating an inner light for yourself, positive affirmations, making sure that everything you see, everything you experience, everything you intake is high vibrational energy, food, the people you're around, the stuff that you watch, everything is high vibrational energy. So that way you can just vibrate high, vibrate to the top, okay? Be lifted, okay? That's what I got for you guys, group number three people. I really hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like, comment, share, subscribe, and all that good stuff. And I hope that you come back to see me another time. I am out. Peace.